Hi, welcome to product test and review by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. We are going to test this Deek-Robot 10 ampere 100 volts DC volt ampere meter. Let's get started with this. This module is very simple with large digital display. The top row shows the voltage. Then the current is shown on the second line, and the third one is the power. So this will be the multiplication of voltage times current is the power, and it can measure up to 1000 watt. The voltage, the maximum voltage it can display is 100 volts, and the maximum current is 10 ampere. This module is offered in 5 ampere and also 10 ampere, 5 ampere and 50 volts, or 10 ampere and 100 volts. So you can connect up to 100 volts, and on this side it has a clip for the panel in case if you have some panel, so you can insert it and it will be clamped on the panel. And another good characteristic of this one is for voltage calibration and current calibration, we have direct access of potentiometer. There is other model that I've done the review. The link will be available below this video. In that one, you need to do a little extra work to adjust it. The benefit for this one is that easily accessible, and you can change it. And we have simple connections here. Three wires here for the voltage, two wires for the current. Let me turn the light off. The light is now off, and this is how you would see it. There is also some backlight from this on this section, and this can be viewed very easily. It's very bright. The length of this is 79.3 millimeters. The width is 42.8 millimeters. If you want to create a hole on the panel and insert it, let me show you. That size is 39.1 millimeter, the width. And the length is 71.4 millimeters. The depth of the module is 41.8 millimeters. With this connector and as much as you can bend it, you need at least 30 millimeters space to put this. And if you're interested in the weight of this, it weighs 32.5 grams. If I want to show you how to measure the current with a current meter, this is the battery and this is the load. The positive enters the device and there is a shunt resistor and passes through. The negative of this goes to the positive. So for the load, this wire is positive because it has just come and passes through. This module does not reduce it. It's just 48 millivolts will be reduced, which I'm going to show you next. And the negative will be connected from this side. So for the load, the positive comes this way, the negative comes this way, and the load will turn on. Doesn't matter if this is inductive load like motor or it's a light or another device. To clarify the operation of this, this needs separate voltage between 7 to 12 volts to operate. So you need to connect separate power supply for this. And then if you need to measure the power, then you need to connect the voltage from the source to this one. And here, that is how it works. We have two wires here. These two, this is will be connected to your power supply for this, 7 to 12 volts. And the red will be connected to the same thing. So let's say you connect 9 volts and it will work. And then to measure the power, you need to connect this white to the battery. And these two are for the current. The current will come here, will pass through this and go. So from positive, if we say, it goes like this and exits. And here is the wiring diagram. The two wires for the power supply will be connected to your 7 to 12 volts. Here, this is green. In our case, it's white. And these two are the large connection, and this is the shunt resistor. here, this is the shunt resistor, and these are the two wires that I just shown you. And the power supply will be connected to these two. So you will connect these two wires to the power supply, and this goes to the source that you are measuring the current. So from your battery, and this is your load, they put small sign. This is, let's say, your bulb, your motor, whatever you have. The positive from your battery goes to the motor, and the negative goes to the negative of the device. The positive enters the device, and there is a shunt resistor, and passes through. And from the other side of the motor, the negative of the motor will be connected to the positive of this thick wire to this one. And then to display the power on the screen, the last pin, which is white, will be connected directly to the battery source that you are connecting to the motor. This one will be connected. So this is the one that wire. And here is how I have connected it. The two wires to power this is that these two wires, the left one, I'm connecting it to a separate source that I have here. This is my 10 volts that I'm connecting just to power this up. Negative to the negative, positive to the positive. So this now has a power. The white is now hanging. And now this is my battery, which I will supply this to my electronic load or motor or whatever I have. These two are my power supply of the battery that I'm connecting to my load. The first thing that I do is that the negative of my battery will be connected to the negative of the meter directly. These two are connected to my electronic load, which could be light, which could be a motor, whatever you have. The positive from the battery will be connected to my load. Now this is connected to the load, this is the load. Left with negative from the load and positive from the using alligator clip to connect the meter to the load. The positive is now connected from the meter to the negative of the load. And the last thing to do is this white wire on this side. If you see it green, that's also fine. The last wire, this is to display the voltage of the load and calculate the power. This will be connected directly to the positive that goes from the battery to the load in here. And now this is connected. Currently the load draws 2.36 ampere, and if you multiply this is the power, 34.2 watts. And if I change the voltage, you will see the power will change, but the current is constant. And let me increase it. And as you can see, we have now 31 volts at the input and 73.1 watts. And let me change it to 5 ampere. Now the current is 5 ampere with 31 volts. As you can see, it's 33 times 5 is 150, so this is 150 watts. Increase the current, let's make it 10 ampere maximum. So now we are drawing 10 ampere from this. Let me see if this is hot. Very nice. I don't feel anything. So the current is very exact. I'm drawing 10 ampere. The voltage is a little off. The actual voltage that I have is 21.4, and here it shows 21.7. Maybe I have some voltage drop on the path. Let me increase the current and see if it can display it. Okay, so 11 also can be displayed. Let's go 15 jump. No, it doesn't display. Even though the current is now 15, it shows 11. Let me go 12. No, 12 is not shown. It shows 11. The actual current is now 12. So let me go 10. So it has been set to display only 10 ampere. And to change the voltage, let's say you want to calibrate the voltage, connect it to a proper voltmeter and then rotate this until you see. So you see, we can go 19.4. Now this is 21.4 proper calibration, and for the current as well, because the current is correct, I'm not touching it. Currently there is 10 ampere passing through this, and it goes through this shunt resistor here. Let's measure the voltage and see how much voltage is dropped across this. So we have 48 millivolts. The negative is due to polarity. If I change the polarity, it will become positive. So there is 48 millivolts drop. Very minimal drop. And for conclusion, I would say that this Deek-Robot DC power meter or current meter, 10 ampere, volt ampere and power meter is very nice, very accurate, easy to use, simple, and it's very bright, and the digits are large. You can see them easily. I have no affiliation with them. I would like to sincerely thank the following people who have supported me via Patreon. Thank you for watching. If you like this video and learn something, please thumb up. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, you may subscribe now.